sex, not sexual intercourse, copulation, or coitus, not gender, not sexual orientation, just sex, pure and simple biological sex. We all need to know about biological sex, but you are right, we also need to learn more about the other sex, but this video is not for that one, sorry. My friend, may I quiz you about your sex knowledge? I will show you images and you choose the alternative you think is right. Here we go. Question number one. Which of the following two birds is the male? Is it bird one or two? If you said one, you are right. The rooster is the male. Notice that I didn't ask you which one had the chromosomes XY because not many people know that one. In birds, the male is not XY, it is ZZ, and the female is ZW, and it is the hen, the one that determines the sex of the offspring. Yeah, biological sex is very diverse across creatures. Question two, which of the two following plants is male and which one female? Is it plant one or plant two? Did you know that male here is plant two? Very well again, but did you know that plant one is hermaphrodite? Papayas have male, female, and hermaphrodite plants. Tricky, eh? Question three, which of the two following birds is male and which one female? Do you know? The answer is no, you don't. No one knows unless you go find out through DNA testing. The fishers' lovebirds have identical sexes. Question four, is the following animal a male or a female? You know this one? Did you notice the red arrow? Well, oddly enough, this is a female. And the clitoris in the spotted hyena can be as large as the male penis. Yes, biological sex is surprising. Question five and final. Are the following human individuals carrying XY chromosomes or XX chromosomes? Do you have an answer? Okay, but what about if instead of telling you whether the answer is right or wrong, you join me in this video to discover the right answer together while we talk about the extraordinary diversity of human sex. If you accept the invitation, I will be waiting for you after the Q1 horns. Our guiding W today within behavioral neuroscience is when, and specifically when we come to be both male and female. Take a look at these photos. Those are so stereotypical. A stereotype is an overgeneralized belief about a particular category of people. For example, our male stereotype is above and our female stereotype is below. And it could be wrong when applied to particular individuals. And it could lead to social categorization and consequently to prejudice. Stereotypes are killers for the intrinsic values of diversity. Hashtag I vote diversity. My friend, I know you could know about unfortunate stereotypes. Would you share with us down in the comments the one stereotype that you detest the most? Please, before I tell you about the three different levels you need to keep in mind when talking about males and females in humans, let us take our disclaimers out of the way. Number one, even when this is only our opinion, it is shared by most other scientists. Number two, we have no time to go in depth, but we hope to give you enough information to expand your current knowledge about human sex. And number three, please find relevant links in the description below, which we always encourage you to check. I don't remember if we have any other disclaimers. Wait. No, I don't remember. Okay, we can move forward. The first level to keep in mind when talking about sex is genetic sex. And there we have to look at the sex chromosome. We all should know that the common case is that an individual with Y chromosome, with stereotypical blue here, is male, right? And the Y chromosome makes a male because it has the SRY gene. If you have SRY, you will be typically male. Also, a common case is that one individual with two X chromosomes, in pink here, is female, and sex could go in different directions already at this stage. How so? Let me mention two out of dozens of those different directions. Different direction number one, the individual ends up with a third sex chromosome to become 47XXY. The 47 here is for the number of chromosomes. in our species is typically 46. Remember, XY is typically a male. XX is typically a female. What about XXY individuals? Well, some would develop as males and some as females. Different direction number two. In the XX male syndrome, the individual has two XX chromosomes, but one of them gets the SRY gene and the individual develops as a typical male. Do you see the person in the picture? From outside, you cannot know about his or her genetic sex. Okay, we have our chromosomes since the moment we are just one cell. But after a few weeks of development, sex keeps battling for its future. Tiny embryo here of 6 weeks. And inside of that embryo, you find this indifferent gonad in brown. It is not a testis and it is not an ovary, but it will become an ovary unless something stops it. And that something is the protein of the SRY gene we just mentioned. If the protein is present, the gonad will become a testis. And then you will have the second level of analysis, gonadal sex. If testes are present, we have a typical male. If ovaries are present, we have typical female. But the sexual differentiation at this level is done especially by one hormone, testosterone. And testosterone brings other challenges for our sex. Let me tell you only about one, and my students will understand this one very fast. Because they all remember that if you have the hormone, testosterone in this case, you only have one half of the story because you also need the receptor for testosterone. Guys, you remember that, right? So in individuals that are males at the levels of genes and gonads with XY chromosomes and with testes, if there is no receptor for testosterone, the rest of the body will develop as female. Could that happen? Definitely. Take the case of Han Gavi Odiel, a well-known and successful model. She has the intersex trait androgen insensitivity syndrome, like in the woman with XY chromosomes that we show you in the introduction. Odiel has described her identity as an intersex woman. One third and last level to keep the conversation about sex, phenotypic sex. Phenotypic sex is about how sex is expressed in our phenotype, in our morphology, our physiology, and our behavior. We pay special attention to the external genitalia because of the obvious, but we are being very superficial here. If everything goes the common way, no testosterone means clitoris and vagina in the female, and testosterone means penis and scrotum in the male. But come closer, testosterone is not doing that specific job by itself. The masculinization of the external genitalia is done by 5-alpha-dehydrotestosterone, which is another hormone synthesized from testosterone. So what? Well, if you have testosterone but no dehydrotestosterone, the individual will have XY chromosomes and testes inside, but at birth, there is no penis and no scrotum. To make it a real special case, these individuals develop the penis and the scrotum after the second wave of testosterone that happens in boys about 12 years of age. Because individuals with this special development are found in the Dominican Republic, they are known with a particular name in Spanish, huevedoses. In English, that name is not very straightforward, but in Spanish, it is huevedoses. ¿Qué es lo que le crece a los 12? Ah. Hey, pay attention here. They are classified as girls when they are born, given girl names and raised as girls. But at 12, they become boys, change their names and seek for girlfriends. That's the case of Johnny here, who was Felicita before 12. And this is the moment when some of you go, Profe, where is behavioral neuroscience in this story? The story of our sex is central in behavioral neuroscience, because our main sexual organ is the brain. Now we face the biggest challenge. Can we tell what is a male brain? No, we cannot. Do we find differences when we compare the brains and behaviors of males and females? Yes, we do. Are boys better at mental rotation of figures, for example? Yes. Do girls perform better at verbal learning? Yes. but the differences are all statistical differences. Take a look inside the blue square. The curves represent the distribution of gray matter volume of two brain regions. The green curve is for male brains, and the red curve for female brains. Do you see how much they overlap? Yes, there are statistical differences, but for most of that range of values, you cannot distinguish a male from a female brain. Wait, because this gets better. These graphics are for two areas that show the largest sex differences we can find. We could have talked with confidence about a male or a female brain if our measures would behave like these ones. There would be variation among the blue male brains and among the red female brains, but there would also be a clear distinction in value ranges between all males and all females. But this is not what happens. What happens is that there is so much overlap that for any given parameter, you will find many male brains in the typical range of females, and vice versa. And for any given individual, for you and for me, if we search enough areas in our brains, we will find many that will show characteristics more commonly found in the other sex. Therefore, when I say that we become both male and female, I am not only talking about the many intersex alternatives of human sex. I also argue that the biological boundary that separates the sexes is much more blurred than what we have thought before. And why is this important? Because we all should contribute to eliminate the very unfortunate prejudices and discriminations of girls and women, based according to some on sexual differences. Whenever we witness lower salaries for women, whenever we witness less opportunities for girls on any country around Earth, we should condemn such injustices and understand that they do not have a biological basis. On a final note, our video is only about sex. But above sex, we should understand that gender and sexual orientation will expectedly, at least, inherit our biological sex diversity. And there, too, we have unfortunate old centuries prejudices and injustices. For the LGBTQ community, our message at inDClazz fits in two cards. Hey, Bobby, do you want to show the cards? My friend Bobby, everybody. Thank you, Bobby. Our support at inDClazz for the LGBTQ community is based on science, faith, and love for our many LGBTQ friends and students. The ones we know personally are strong, smart, funny, and loving people. That's it. I finish with this quote from the novel Annabelle of Kathleen Winter about an intersex child. Whenever she imagined her child grown up without interference from a judgmental world, she imagined its male and female halves as complementing each other and as being secretly almost magically powerful. Dear friends, please stay safe. God bless you and see you next week.